you meet this powerful,
malicious characters.
Lie in ruins, no more!
With this film, all my first choices came on board.
I only offer a route to the renewal of faith for all men.
How humble. Our savior, Bishop Aringarosa. How dare you presume to—
I do not presume, I act!
From a storytelling standpoint, I've always believed that characters are, they really are the pillars on which you build everything. And the story is populated by pretty fascinating, very distinct characters. What a luxury to take a character like Aringarosa. He's a major character, but he's not the major character. And to pull in somebody of the caliber of Alfred Molina to play this part.
I just finished a year in Broadway and I was having this vacation and we were sitting around the pool of the hotel where we were staying, and I noticed there were like at least 10 or 11 people were reading Da Vinci Code in hardback. And I remember thinking, wow, this is really... And then suddenly everywhere I went, people were talking about it, people were saying, have you read it, you know? And I thought, I'd better read this. And then, you know, I had a meeting with Ron and Brian, and it all sounded like a really great sort of project, and then, you know, it all worked out.
Alfred Molina is an actor that I've wanted to work with for a long time. He plays Bishop Aringarosa, who's Spanish, and Alfred has some Spanish in his heritage, but he's English. So that's bending my rule just a little bit. But he certainly understood the character and the culture that the character comes from in ways that were far more sophisticated and authentic than was even really required. So that extra level of truth, I think, again, found its way into his character and onto the screen.
Christ sacrificed his life for the betterment of humanity. So too may be the fate of his seed.
The bishop's actual name, Aringarosa, actually means, I think it's Italian for red herring. And in a way, that's the purpose of the character. He's an integral part of the plot. But you're sort of drawn towards him because you think he might be the bad guy. He might be the guy who's essentially, you know, controlling and manipulating this situation. And then, of course, you discover that he's just an employee. You know, he's a worker bee like everyone else.
He used me. God uses us all.
So it was important to make sure that the character, A, served the plot and kept the story going, but also that you didn't give away so much that the audience gets ahead of you. So we wanted to find a way of playing him that wasn't going to set off alarm bells and give anything away.
And Aringarosa obviously calls him an angel.
Eres un ángel.
And action!
It's somebody who's involved with that kind of control that a group has.
You know, Silas is supposed to wear sandals. Thought everything looked great.
A plate of eggs and a cup of tea in his hand, and we would see him again next time.
Ave, O Rector.
Domicilium operis Dei, elegia ad permutationem.
King of the tooth, king of the second take? We would come onto the set in the morning, and Ron would explain roughly what he was hoping to achieve. You know, he explained the shot that he'd planned. He explained how the scene was going to work, how the shots were going to work. He would tell us exactly what we needed to know in terms of what was technically required and so on. And then he would clear the set, and it would just be him and the actors, and usually Akiva, and we would just work on the scene.
If we are discovered by the Vatican, we are excommunicated, so
should anything go?
One of the amazing things about working with Ron and on this process is he understands and values the utility of writers while making a movie, which is very rare in Hollywood.
Cut, great. Good. Well, one more.
So often what happens is the movie's written, and then there's nobody there to continue to help the words and structure evolve while the movie's being made. And that's different from everything else, because although costumes or sets are all designed before the movie, the head of each department remains as part of the movie, so adjustments can be made. And so rarely in Hollywood is that true of words, but words are such an important component of making movies. So that's one of the amazing things about working with Ron.
It's really, your shot works best, Candide, for the very first part of it, so...
He would say, do you like that? Does that work for you? Are you happy with that? Would you like to change it? You know, is there anything else you'd like to do? So it's very collaborative.
Old friend, heaven protect you.
one of those iconic images now, isn't it? You see it sells everything from movies to cars to, you know. I mean, I even saw a pair of boxer shorts that had a facsimile of the Mona Lisa.